Greetings, everyone, and welcome to the Creative Outlet Podcast for July 5th, 2021. As you know, my name is Brandon Pudwill. I'm your host, and woo, we made it to episode 10. We're officially out of single-digit land, which, man, isn't that wild? This number of episodes was my goal for year one, but, you know, it's never... Wow, it's better late than never. I apparently cannot say common phrases that people use all of the time. As I said, today is July 5th, 2021. You should have just seen an episode come out on this very same day. And before we get started, I just want to share kind of keeping on that schedule. So yeah, so far I'm keeping on schedule, at least for sure with these episodes. And I just want to state that there will not be a new episode recorded in 2 weeks. That is July 19th, 2021, as I will be celebrating not my birthday, but a birthday that day. So I will be out and unavailable to record. This will be releasing that day, but there just won't be an episode coming 2 weeks after that on August 2nd, 2021. But there should still be one after that, fortunately, right before we get to the fall semester already. I guess that's the one thing about doing these every 2 weeks is that they take time to come out, and that means obviously there's not a ton of time until the fall semester that begins. On the plus side, though, that does give me some more time to edit up the fall episodes, as I'm currently behind on that. I still only have one completed. Second one is in progress, and it really shouldn't be that hard to do, I would imagine. But fortunately, the couple that are recorded so far should be pretty easier ones to edit. The three that I have, hopefully this week, going to end up with number 4 of 7 done, and then hopefully the last three after that. We'll have to see. As far as other typical intro-y things I talk about, like I love to do my production updates. So if you remember last time I talked about this podcast class I took for school, and I talked about all of the various tools of the trade that I learned about. And I tell you, I learned about another tool in Audacity that I wasn't taught about in class, because this new version of Audacity that I'm using answered my wishes from last time, my wishes for, if only I could have easier normalization, because normalization is a real pain, because you have to go and comb through every single little bit of audio to try to get the peaks to be at the right level. But fortunately, I learned about this new feature called loudness normalization, which is like regular normalization, but instead of using decibels, it uses this unit called LUFS, and it's basically just an acronym for what we would call loudness units. I don't know the exact term, but the simple way of describing it is instead of... So, like, the way that normalization works with the peaks is that Audacity tries to adjust the volume based on decibels. So whatever is the highest decibel, it's going to, you know, the whole audio clip that you highlight is going to be limited to whatever the highest peak is out of the whole area. It'll reach a certain level of decibels. But the way that LUFS works is, instead of adjusting it that way, it's more precise to make all of the audio sound similarly loud. So I talked about last time how I actually talk pretty quietly on here, despite the fact that I feel like I'm actually projecting pretty well, but I digress. So what it does is it adjusts to these LUF units to make my voice sounds similarly loud no matter how quietly I'm actually talking. You see what I'm saying? So a sound that on the microphone registers as like negative 21 decibels, or at least that's what it shows, could sound the same as if I had normalization it up to negative 4 decibels. And it'll just sound a similar loudness throughout, and that way you folks don't have to be messing around with the volume knob throughout listening to me. So, I mean, yeah, as far as the science is concerned, I'm probably pretty well butchering that description, and I'm sure there are audiophiles listening to this just bashing their head against the wall at how little information I really and truly have. But I can only tell you based on what I know. And really, those are the basics that you need to know, is that the point is I should sound similarly loud throughout. And I already applied that in episode 9, and I should be able to continue here in episode 10, our first double-digit episode, which will give our audio listeners a better experience. I could even see myself with the audio episodes remastering episodes 1 through 8 with this, especially because I'd want to apply the musical intro and outro to those as I just started doing up again with, I think I did it in episode 8, but I for sure did it in episode 9. But I have not decided yet. If I go ahead and do the music, then you can probably assume that LUFS was applied to the episode as well. I can't really do that for the video podcast, because I would have to run the audio separately through Audacity and then re-import the audio and hope that it all just lines up properly. And I have not gone through and seen how easily, conveniently would that work. Although I'm sure if I tried hard enough, I could figure it out. But it would probably take some time. As far as distribution, I have some distribution updates. And though I cannot see it on anchor.fm for whatever reason, I have found out that the Creative Outlet podcast is available on other platforms as well, if you prefer them. Platforms that I haven't already originally had them on audio-wise. You can now find the Creative Outlet podcast on CastBox, TuneIn Radio, and the most important addition to the COP repertoire, at least now as far as I'm aware of it. I'm sure there are folks who could have well already been aware of it. The Creative Outlet podcast is now also available on Apple Podcasts, which is the largest podcast platform on the planet, is what I want to say. So I just want to welcome in my iOS listeners, even though I am admittedly an Android fellow here. I also want to establish some corrections from episode 9. So that was our primarily E3 special that focused almost entirely on announcements from the Electronics Entertainment Expo 2021. One of the games I talked about is one that I'm interested in is Riders Republic, which is only available on PlayStation 4, PlayStation 5, Xbox Series X, Xbox One, and PC. So that makes it pretty hard to play it as somebody who probably does not own a sufficient PC for it and doesn't have access to an Xbox One all the time. So we'll see if I end up playing it. Again, because I spent so much time just editing episode 9 leading all the way up to even this morning for the upload, I have not done much more research into it other than looking up the image that I used in the video, so can't say no much more about it. So who knows, it could very well be a game that I'm not interested in, but from what little I saw, it actually seemed pretty interesting. Similarly, I also want to establish that Back 4 Blood was one of the games I talked about in the Xbox and Bethesda showcase. I believe I said it was announced in that episode at E3, but it was actually announced at the 2020 Game Awards, so it's been around the block a little longer than I made it sound. I think there are a couple of other things I wanted to correct, but I can't remember what they were. If I give episode 9 another listen through, or if folks point them out, I'm very happy to correct them, but I am blanking on the other things at the moment. We will get into our full topic discussion here soon, but I actually wanted to give a brief short story. That's something I haven't done in an intro in a while, is just talk about, hey, here's like a short story that I don't think I could get a full topic out about, but let's just talk about it in the intro. So if you've been on the internet in the last few weeks, you probably saw this Game Boy Advance post on Twitter and Nintendo's YouTube channel. And essentially what they posted was, hey, the Game Boy Advance is 20 years old, and here's a celebratory image of it. And it was just an image of a Game Boy Advance playing Super Mario Advance, just to celebrate that, again, GBA is 20 years old, which is nuts to me, but we can talk about that separately a different time. And the whole big brouhaha theory that came out from this image, to me, was a story that is a prime example for why I choose not to post why to report on leaks and rumors and theories and all that business. Because like I talked about last time when I was talking about how the Great Ace Attorney Chronicles, a game that I'm very much excited for later this month, was leaked in November of 2020, I had no idea if that actually was gonna happen. Obviously that one ended up being real, and I'm very happy that it's real, but at the time I had no idea if it really and truly would become a real game. And that's a similar situation that happened here. So not too long before the E3 presentation, Nintendo made these posts, and fans took to ridiculous levels of speculation and found out that, well, if you rearrange the numbers in the score in Super Mario Advance, you can manipulate them to create June 23rd, 2021. And Mario has 96 lives, so if you switch out 2021 for 1996, what do you get? Launch date of the Nintendo 64 in Japan. That means clearly, this is a soft announcement for Nintendo 64 games coming to Switch Online. Because June 23rd, 2021 would be exactly 25 years to the day after the N64 launched in Japan. So, it's gonna happen. Boom. And then it never happened because the screenshot was not a ploy to soft announce N64 games coming to Switch Online, because, as it turns out, the Super Mario Advance screenshot that Nintendo posted, or that they just photoshopped into this GBA, actually dates back to a British Game Boy-focused magazine, where they had the exact same screenshot for Super Mario Advance there, meaning that the screenshot meant nothing! Ugh. I'm sorry, that just stuck out to me as an infuriating case where, man, folks, you gotta curb your hype and not get into complete wild speculation land, because sometimes you're gonna make yourself look like a fool when you notice things like that, and I do not want any part of that. Like, I mean, I'm proud of the person who came up with this theory, noticing all of these details and trying to piece all of this together. But sometimes you just gotta look at something at face value and realize that it just is what it is. Nintendo's just celebrating that the Game Boy Advance is 20 years old, and that's all they're doing. So, with that out of the way, this is probably one of the shortest intros I've had in a while, or at least it feels pretty short, even if it isn't necessarily that much shorter. So we're just going to go into our topic rundown. Like I said last time, today we're going to have a more traditional four-topic episode. So we're going to be having, of course, my obligatory Smash character discussion now that another one has been revealed and, of course, released before I could do coverage of it, and I only have one more chance to try to do this on time. So if anything, expect a Creative Outlet bonus during the semester covering it instead of a regular full-on episode, because I already have my Creative Outlet birthday gaming extravaganza fall episodes already planned. We're gonna have a discussion of Kazuya Mishima from Tekken entering Super Smash Bros. Ultimate. We're going to have a discussion on a topic that I've teased for a while, on what should the Wii U legacy be now that we're a few years out and we keep seeing all of these Wii U to Nintendo Switch game ports, particularly from Nintendo. I'm going to have a broader, more real-world story here that just caught my eye as really interesting, and I actually think, even though you could describe it as political, I think it's actually very apolitical, and kind of gets into the title of why this is destroying a legacy. We're going to talk about how Amazon UK is apparently destroying goods at their warehouses. And finally, we are going to close off this episode with my first impressions of Mario Golf Super Rush now that I have had it for about 10 days. So, without further ado, I suppose we should get into our very first topic here.